That's really what we're looking for. Now we know that all of these troops are Aragonese, and we should be able to take them on without too much of a fuss. Glorious vassals. Attack. Less glorious vassals. Also attack. Doesn't seem to be any rebel problems around it. England, what are you doing? No, no, there's no way you'd have any colonies down there. Castilian colony doing awful, which is great. It's hard work being the battle pope. Everybody keeps expecting these things of you. Right. That is going up at an unpleasant rate. Let's keep you out of there, because the attrition isn't helping any. Jake, expiring casus belli. Yeah, that trade conflict's only going to last for a wee bit longer. We're going to have to wrap up and fight Burgundy. Trouble is, if I fight Burgundy now, I'm going to have to peace out with England and sell those provinces to Northumberland, which means peacing out very shortly. The odds of bankrupting England at this rate are minimal. Because he makes so much money from the trade node. Oh, yeah, I could take war reps while we're at it. It might help a little. But yeah, the amount of money he'll make from the trade node will more than pay off his loans. Probably also give him a whole bunch more of available loans. God, that and this war with Aragon isn't over either. No, you know, what's the rush? Why don't we just get another war with Burgundy? Fabricate another trade conflict. You've already justified one. Jake, get his trade power and war reps. Nah, trade power is not something I'm really interested in. You know what? Castile's colony is doing so badly. We should just wait it out. If anything, I can just hold off and fight Castile directly. That truce isn't going to last too much longer. In fact, only a year. And that colony is not going to be completed in that time. We'll sit on England for a while longer. Since you control the majority of the English Channel, would it be beneficial to to embargo England? He makes no money off of it at all, so no good for him. What does he even make money from then? Taxation, production, and vassals. You know, why don't we stroll across that strait now? There's only a few lightships. We take what's left of his land. Let's see if it can be done. Get our good explorer on the case. England must go bankrupt. Jake, if you're eradicating all blah blah blah, does that include Orthodox? Yes. And thank goodness Muscovy still don't have expansion. Oh, I did not see that coming. But thankfully my vassals did. I went in there without a general like a fool. Back me up there, will you? You've got four shock. Oh yeah. I wonder if England's scared of me there. It is still England. I reckon his navy could floor me. good. It was just Mercs that took the beating there. Still gonna merge them up though. Who needs generals? Well, fighting in Girona, I probably will. That's a really bad thing to fight into. But, let's do it anyway. Come on, lads. We need to help Girona. Ah, well, that's okay. What he'll do is we'll win this battle, no doubt. He'll probably run to Barcelona. No, he won't. Okay, that suits me just fine. That's a stack wipe, whatever way you cut it. Or not, okay. Let's continue with the bankruptcy of England. Just raising troops, that can't be cheap. Particular month there, there's no way. There is no way. We'll move from Barcelona, so hopefully he'll run to Barcelona. If not, he'll probably go for Aragon. Victory every way you look. Naples are taking care of that, so there we go. It was not the easiest war we've ever fought, but total victory. Go, go, Jake, show those scrubs who's boss. I assure you, it is me. You know what would really be not funny is if they were receiving subsidies from someone like France. You know what, I'm not even gonna let you have that unit. You're going to make them rise up and I will kill them, and that will make you lose even more money. Because if I just stop over it, you'll cancel it and you'll get half of the money back, roughly. Glorious loot. Now go bankrupt. Come on, you know you want to. Yeah, income's falling even more. And when it comes to, they don't have many loans, only like 7. Loans are so large because it's based off your base tax. I could be satisfied with this though. Alright, we are fast approaching Admin Tech 10. Funnily enough, it's Modern Theocracy, which I think is a great moment to be choosing to convert to a better religion. No, we'll pass for now. I'm doing okay on the money front. Jake, vassalize Aragon and then feed them land. I'd love to. But they're much too big. No, instead I will feed them, probably to Granada. Since Granada has no problem dealing with heathens. Oh, right, I forgot about killing these guys. Oh, terrible. How could I forget about killing? Oh, he dismissed them straight away! This joker. He knows what's coming. What did Scotland instantly kill there? Sardinia's independent. If I took them, I'd be able to get a claim down here where I need to be. Maybe I should do a province count myself. Galicia haven't got Diptech 7 yet, and they've still got this decrepit, useless bishopric. Emphasis on part of that. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 provinces. How many can I get rid of to soften the load? Probably get rid of Arguin and Cape Verde and Sierra Leone if I can. I'm sure I can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yeah, that should be fine. Take loads of low base tax, crappy land down there. Jake, did Granada convert their provinces? It would be lovely if they did, but I almost guarantee you, well, I guarantee you that they did not. 6 base tax and 7 base tax. It was a pipe dream, really. Coming. Alright, England, this is getting a little bit ridiculous. It is high time that you just popped. England treasury is 37, huh? And it's still 37? They got rid of everything, so they can't... I would have to wait for those loans to come due, and if we remember Muscovy, that takes a while. Unless, of course, I took loads of their money, forcing them to take another loan. Maybe. We'll let the noble rebs take London first, though. The lengths I go to. All settings are on default, McMarshall. Okay, our good ally Poland getting the peasant war now. As they integrate the Teutons, guess we're going to have to come to blows over that at some point. The Teutons lose their cores. No, I'm just being blind. We do have to pick them up for the Holy Trinity achievement, but all in due time. Done good. Get out of there, guys. Free diplomats, so you never know when we're going to need that claim on Sardinia. Or France. Jake, English colony south of Jolof. That's not English. Don't scare me like that. What in the world makes you think that's English? Nah, maybe you're colorblind, in which case, my bad. Oh, I didn't even leave enough for Ulster. England would never afford colonies yet, not right now. In fact, I wish they had a colony, because that would be sending them into bankruptcy. At the moment, they're just chilling. Just jiving. I really think I might just have to peace out like this, regrettable as it may be. Could make myself another vassal, though. I could take Ulster as my vassal. And... no, they don't accept English as a culture, just Irish. Of course, I could feed them Ireland, but that's a little limited in scope. It is a real shame that Scotland isn't my vassal. Or that I have York with cores here. But at the very least, we have no overextension. We take Northumberland, and we can hold on to some ourselves. For the most part, just try to rip this guy's coast off of him. Oh, looking at Aragorn again here. And I could feed these piece by piece, I'm sure he'd take them happily enough. You better believe I'm taking your reparations, I want you out of this game. There's just no good reason to do that. We'll probably do it anyway. Ayrshire too. Scotland do like to... Hold on, Scotland are... Of all people. No, they're not going to care at all. They're going to be my ally. There's no need to worry about Ayrshire. If I can just cancel the vassalage of Tyrone instead. Stop some integrating them later. Amazingly, though, he doesn't want that. It's too much, apparently. Oh, that's right, and I'm going to lose war score once London falls. Well, London will fall shortly once we come out of this anyway. Still, I want to take as much money as I can. Maybe I should forget about cancelling Tyrone and instead... Release Leinster. How does that look? Any objections to doing that to England? Should weaken them significantly. Jake, take Connaught. It's closer to the Americans than Iceland. Connaught is English, which is a bit problematic. Alright, let's do it. I really hope England go bankrupt to the end of all this. However, that's going to use a lot of dip points. Let's use exploits that I never use twice. Bit of a waste teching up there now, isn't it? I can't afford the modern theocracy, and I certainly don't want any of these. So, might as well just tech up. And tech up. That's a really old exploit. You can go to minus 100 diplopower, and then you cancel your culture conversions and get it back. Lovely. Oh, that's right, I need to finish this war up. Yeah, try and remember what you're doing for a change, Jake. Might save your life. Still, with this war, what really is there to do? Give some land to Granada and call it a day. Granada can core a couple. These two go to our good vassal. Of course, we need our guy home. You know, I'm questioning how much I need this claim on France right now, when what I really need are a couple of free diplomats. So yeah, you're giving that to... This actually might be a bit too expensive. You get to save a few of your shekels, you lucky sod. And yes, everybody hates us, but who doesn't hate us at this stage? Yeah. Granada looking good. Unfortunately, I gave him a centre of trade that I kinda wanted for myself, but what you gonna do? Transfer trade power using our English Channel guy, since we're no longer going to control the English Channel. And... Let us create Northumberland. Now, what's Northumberland going to want? Hopefully we can give them Cumbria and Lancashire. They spawn with no admin points. Ugh, they get a one admin ruler as well, which is not good for us. Well, we'll help him with any revolts he's going to have. We don't care much about this territory, but I'll probably lower the autonomy here and here, since he won't keep the lowered autonomy problems. So despite me being an all-round good guy here, Munster is less than impressed. Well, what are they going to do about it? I don't think Granada's going to be exploring under my watchful eye anytime soon. Okay. I'm a bit unsure here, though, because we need our troops everywhere at this point. We are spread really thin, and we're about to go to war with Castile and Burgundy. Now, normally Burgundy wouldn't get access through France, but France hate me, they will probably give access. Our truce is up, but Poland want to join in. Okay, that's lovely, they can take care of Hungary for us. Still lose Burgundy on our side. The truce will be up. The truce is already up, but takes a month to reconsider. You know, English patriots, if you wanted to defect to... Damn. With the truce up, that means it's coalition o'clock. And France might join that coalition. We already have Munster and Castile together. Do I dare wait a month? I need to burn Castile to the ground, and I need to not have France be part of that situation. We're a little weakened here. We could get caught with our pants right around our waists. Alright, here's what we'll do then. We'll get everybody over to Almeria in this fashion. I'm fairly certain Castile can still field quite an army. But what do we even call this? Nobody has claims that really matter. Claim revocation, monetary, trade power, I don't want any of these things. Jake, make Northumberland a march. No, I'll be integrating them at some point, so there's no real good reason to do that. Just to be sure, we don't have a truce with France, meaning they are keen to join that coalition, especially with 146 aggressive expansion. Yeah, whole of the HRE isn't particularly pleased with me right now. Yeah, waiting around is only going to get me killed. What do I even call this? None of these are what I want. Badajoz is probably one of the easiest ones to take, so I could take Badajoz. And it also allows me to give Badajoz to anybody I want. That is a worthwhile endeavor. Well, Poland don't want to join in now because they're too in debt. But Hungary still want to join in despite being ravaged by rebs. Ah, but hold on. Poland don't like Hungary. They'll probably join in when they see that. Give me Badajoz. There's no time. I had to do it before France joined the coalition. So yeah, you don't want to join in. You still don't want to join in. You have your peasant war as well, though, so it's probably not wise for you any way you cut it. Castile have a fleet, but it's just trade ships. We have a fleet, but it's not much better. Also, I forgot to reduce the autonomy in Cumbria. Full of mistakes, me. Let's raise the autonomy here and here, though, so we don't have to deal with their revolts. Lancashire, not such a problem. But we need all of our troops down there. And those are not transports. Timed that well. Again, we need to take that province, but we will deal with it once we secure the Castilian coastline. Oh, also, please attach to me, because Castile probably means to hurt us. Jake, send Poland a gift, they're in debt. Yeah, but I mean, I didn't get all this money by sending gifts everywhere. Actually, I did. I want an embassy, so that's good enough reason. Hopefully nobody besieges Roma, that would be embarrassing. Burgundy have no fleet, as I recall, so they're not exactly a threat. Speaking of not a threat, hello Munster. Please don't sink my transports. They're necessary. Speaking of please don'ts. Naples, no! He could siege Hungary for me, but Hungary's under the coalition, they're just an ally. Besides, getting them out of this war won't take long. And actually, getting Poland means getting Lithuania as well, so it's probably not a bad idea. 130 in debt. I'm gonna miss you, money. Pay off your debt. Maybe 130 is one loan for him. Okay, our manpower is still pretty shot, so let's take it easy. Let Castile come to us. There's every possibility they'll get that event that gives you like 300 settlers in one province. Here's me hoping that he does not. Speaking of things I'm hoping not for, I'll have to save you in Asteras. We have two maneuver, but we're... Hopefully Castile get a river crossing. If they do not, we're probably going to add our own penalty onto this. But it's worth it to defeat Castile. Castile, who have not many troops. In fact, that's everything they have. Alright folks, no longer need to attach to me. It's time for all-out aggression. How, where, and how quickly is he raising these troops? Very quickly. Too quickly for me. Alright. Gank him on this side then. And the troops that we're landing now, they can be used later. Hello, Burgundy's Navy. Please don't run into me. Please continue to not run into me. Three transports, huh? That battle does not look to be going in our favour. Bah. Well, we still have more troops to throw at him. Okay. It's going from bad to worse here. Now France want a piece of the cake again. That coalition's pretty damn big. Huh. Well, that seems like a pretty good point to wrap it up for tonight. We will figure out how to deal with this at a later date, which will probably be tomorrow evening around about 6 p.m. GMT. Because I've made quite a lot of mistakes over this session, and I don't think that's going to change as this goes on. Tuscany got the balls. Really, what I should be doing is taking it easier. But how can I take it easy knowing that there are all these Catholic colonizers still in the world? All right, I'll puzzle this one out next time. As for me, time to go. Thanks everyone for joining, and tomorrow evening. That should be when I continue. No guarantees, of course. Ciao for now.